Welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing a beginner's guide to barbells. So if you've ever walked into a gym and wanted to use a barbell before, but felt too intimidated or didn't know what to do, this video is for you. Let's hop right in. Okay, so we have three different kinds of bars. This first one is called a training bar. It is 15 pounds, and we're never gonna exceed 65 pounds on this bar total. So if you're trying to do any kind of strength work, we won't be using a training bar. This is just for training purposes. Our second bar is a quote unquote women's bar, which is a little bit ridiculous, but it is a little bit narrower of a circumference, and it is 33 pounds. And then lastly, we have the men's bar, which is a little bit of thicker circumference, and it is 45 pounds. This is the bar that I will be using today. So once you grab your barbell, you're gonna bring it to your rig. This is called a rig, and then you are going to set up your J-hooks. So this is called a J-hook. They look a little different at each gym. And you have to play around with them a little bit to figure out how to get them to work. So for this one, you push it all the way through, and then you let it slide in. You wanna make sure that these two J-hooks are even, and once they are, then you can set up your barbell. Your J-hooks are gonna be at a different height for whatever lift you are doing. So let's make sure that this is even. Yes, we are good to go here. So that's how you set up your rig. Okay, so once I bring my barbell onto that rig, into my J-hooks, we can take a little bit of a closer look at what is on the barbell. So you'll see this textured part right here that is on most barbells is called the knurling. The knurling gives you a little bit of extra grip because of that texture, but it also allows you to figure out where you should be placing your hand so that they're even, right? So if I have one hand right here on the knurling and then one hand over by this notch, I know that if I go for a back squat, I'm gonna be super uneven, right, to one side. So the knurling can be super helpful in figuring out if you are even on the barbell. So let's talk about how to load the barbell with weights. So number one rule, we wanna make sure that we are loading the barbell as evenly as possible. So if you're putting 25 pounds on one side, we wanna make sure that we're putting 25 pounds on the other side. This isn't gonna be a huge problem. You could probably have 100 pounds on this side and 0 pounds on this side, and it's still not gonna tip out of the rack, but we still wanna be as even as possible. So for our weights, we've got tons of different options, and it's gonna be different for each gym. So we've got a 45 pound plate here, a 25 pound plate here, 10 pound plate, and a 5 pound plate, and then our clip. So I'm gonna go ahead and put a 25 pound plate onto our bar. I'm just gonna load this on really nice and tight. And then I'm going to grab my clip, and I'm just gonna tell you, I think this is the most complicated part of the gym. These can be very temperamental, and sometimes they're very easy, sometimes they're very hard. What you're gonna do, use both hands. Don't be a hero here. Squeeze it together as hard as you can, slide it on, and then you can let go. You'll see that that plate isn't really gonna move too much. We wanna make sure that everything is nice and snug all the way to the center of the barbell, okay? Let's do it on the other side. Grab it with both hands, slide it on, okay? And now we are ready to lift some weight. A couple of general rules. You are always going to use clips on your barbell unless you're doing a bench press without a spotter. There are always some small exceptions, but generally we are always gonna be using clips. Number two, when we are adding weight to the barbell, we generally wanna add it from the heaviest weight and then go down to the lightest weight. And then you'll put the clip on the end of the lightest weight. Okay, so now that we've checked that we have even weight on both sides of our barbell, let's talk about a few tips for while you're actually using the barbell. So if I was back squatting, for example, we could pick up our bar, make sure that our hands are even, and then we can take two steps back. From here, we pick it up, one step, two step, and then we can do our squats, right? We don't need to be taking six steps back from the rig. Secondly, when we return that bar to the rig, we wanna make sure that we are firmly on those J-clips before we walk away, right? What I see a lot from people is that you're still a step away from the rig and you lean into it and then maybe miss one side of it, and that can be super dangerous, right? So we wanna make sure that regardless of how much noise you're making, you walk it all the way in, and then you can bring that weight down into the J-clips safely. So we don't have to go super heavy to get a great workout and a great pump. You should not be anywhere near failing a rep with the barbell at this point in your lifting career. But if it happens, if you are doing a back squat and you have to dump the weight, that's fine. It might make some noise. It's fine. It happens to everyone, and we'll go into how to do that safely in future videos. So if you're nervous that you're not going to be able to complete a rep, take some weight off. It's just not worth it in this point in your fitness career. Lastly, if the bar is on the ground, say that we were deadlifting or something, and we are taking our weight off, there is a proper way to do this. Sometimes you will see people pulling weight off of the barbell and then the barbell smacks into the ground, which can be really damaging to how the barbell spins. So rather than pulling weight off, we are going to lift up that barbell and slide the weight off onto the ground, because the weights can fall onto the ground and still be safe, but we want to be nice and gentle with the actual barbell. Try not to hog the equipment. Have a purpose when you come to the gym, have a plan, and try and get in and get out, right? That doesn't mean that you can't take your time. You can still rest for 90 seconds, but there's a difference between resting 90 seconds between sets and resting for 5 minutes scrolling through Instagram. Secondly, if you see someone concentrating super hard at the gym, they are looking straight ahead, do not walk in their eye contact, right? Wait for them to finish their lift, and then you can walk through their line of sight. So before long, you're gonna feel like a pro at the gym. And one of the biggest things I want you to remember is not to judge people for where they are, right? We were all beginners once, and the gym should always be a judgment-free zone. It never is, but we don't want to contribute to that kind of toxic culture, right? So try not to judge people at the gym. Remember where you started, where you're starting right now, and be kind to everyone. Number four, if you need help, ask for it. If you need a spotter, ask for it. If you need someone to watch your deadlift, ask for it. It is so much better than you getting injured because you had too big of an ego and you didn't want to ask for help. And lastly, the best way to make friends at the gym is to make sure that we are cleaning up our space fully. Even if you got to a rig and there was equipment out from the person previous, we want to make sure that we are cleaning up every single piece of equipment so that we leave our space as clean as possible. So I hope these tips were helpful. If you're able to follow these kind of rules of the gym, there's really nothing to be embarrassed about when you walk in and start using a barbell. We still have so much to learn, how to back squat properly, how to deadlift, how to fail a rep, but the best thing that you can do for yourself is just get started. Can't wait to see you at the gym.